Looking for a new or used vehicle? The Auto Channel has dozens of searchable databases with the latest pricing information, in-depth specifications, and tons of reviews, and it's all available free.
The Institute is releasing bumper test results for 6 midsize cars. These tests assess how well the bumper protects the expensive sheet metal parts on a car in low-speed collisions. Bumpers are supposed to take the hit in low-speed crashes and keep damage away from expensive parts like headlamps, fenders, and grills. Bumpers need to be tall so that they protect the vehicle from underriding other cars that they hit, and they also need to be wide so that they protect the vehicle's corners. Our low-speed tests look at how well bumpers are designed to protect your wallet and everyday fender benders. Your bumper should be the first line of defense when somebody stops suddenly in front of you or hits you from behind in commuter traffic. The Institute evaluates low-speed crash protection in a series of 4 tests. Each vehicle hits this barrier, which is designed to replicate a typical car bumper. It has an energy absorber and a bumper cover. Front and rear impacts are run at 6 miles an hour, and front and rear corner impacts are run at 3 miles an hour. Only one vehicle earns an acceptable rating. 5 others earn ratings of marginal or poor. The Mazda 6 is the best performer in this group and the only vehicle to earn an acceptable rating. Its bumpers are wider, taller, and higher off the ground than the 2007 model. This kept damage costs below $800 in 3 of the 4 tests. Mazda is looking out for their buyers' pocketbooks, while other manufacturers aren't paying so much attention. Some manufacturers are going backwards on bumper design. The new Ford Fusion has almost $900 damage, more than its previous design, in part because the headlamps now protrude beyond the bumper, and the bumper is much smaller than in the previous version. The Chevy Malibu is the worst performer in this group. It had almost $3,500 damage in the rear full test and over $2,000 damage in the front full test. Part of the reason is that you have to go through $625 of grille and chrome trim before you even hit the front bumper. People buy mid-sized cars for practical reasons, but there's nothing practical about spending thousands of dollars in repair bills after a minor collision. Most mid-sized cars allow far too much damage in low-speed crashes.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great automotive information and entertainment, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.